And joining us on the line to tell us the latest developments on the Azkals is Dyan Castillejo, reporting from Myanmar. Dyan?
Good morning. It's 8:20 in the morning here in Myanmar time. The game will start at 3:30 p.m. at the Azkals Stadium. This is a different stadium from where the Philippines played the first two games against Myanmar and Palestine. The Azkals are getting ready for breakfast now. They're going to have a lot of carbohydrates, and they'll do the same thing for lunch, do a little walk just to get ready for the game this afternoon. Last night, there was a 7.0 magnitude earthquake here in Myanmar, which occurred about 8:25 p.m., and this happened just as the Azkals were watching a video of the Bangladesh game, just to get a little bit more information about how they move and to set up their place. So they all felt that they started getting dizzy, and then soon enough realized it was an earthquake. Half of them ran down the stairway exit down all the way to the lobby. Others stayed in the ninth floor until the tremor stopped. After about 30 minutes, the team was calmed down. They all went back to their rooms and started joking around again and thinking about the big game today against Bangladesh. The team feels that they're better skilled. We have better ball handling, but of course, we need to win today, so we have to be very aggressive. So they're going to put more people up front. Bangladesh is expected to double up on their defense to prevent the Philippines from scoring. The exciting thing about this final day of the game, Paulo, is that all four teams, depending on the result today, all of them have a chance to qualify, make sure the top two and qualify. Myanmar, Bangladesh, Palestine, and the Philippines. So nobody's out. Everybody's in the running. So everybody's going to go for the win. The Bangladesh team are on the same floor as I am here in the Yangon Hotel, and they're very excited about their last win against Myanmar. They upset the host nation 2-0. So they feel they can do the same for the Philippines. Our guys are super ready. They want to qualify for the Challenge Cup. It's never been done before. They've never played against Bangladesh. And they are really going for the win this afternoon. Paulo.
Dyan, it's my understanding that aside from Phil Young husband not being present, another key player is actually not going to be able to be playing in the next game. How will this affect the game of the Azkals?
Yep, that's right. Unfortunately, one of our best defensive players, Rob Gere, had to fly back to England yesterday afternoon. He played excellent the first two games against Palestine and Myanmar, but he had to go home. His wife is having a baby and is a little bit under the weather, so he had to be by his wife's side. Although this was already known prior to his coming out here that he could only come out for two games, so he had to go back home. Well, you know, it is going to affect the team because he has been one of the better players in our last two games. But, you know, that's the way it is in football. Sometimes players get injured. Sometimes some of their key players are not here. Phil, of course, is injured, and Rob had to go back for various reasons. So they're just going to have to make do with what they have, and everybody is psyched. We have a lot of players here who need to step up, and it'll be a big step for Philippine football if we can make it to this Challenge Cup, because we've never qualified for this tournament before.
All right, Dyan, regarding the earthquake, do you think this will affect the spectators, the number of people who will actually be present at the game?
There are not really too many spectators who watch the games when it's not Myanmar playing. Mm-hmm. So I don't expect it to really affect the spectators who will be coming to the stadium. We're actually playing in a smaller stadium today. The main stadium is going to be used for the other game between Myanmar and Palestine. So both games are going to be played simultaneously today, both starting at 3:30 p.m., unlike in the past 2 days where one game was at 3:30 and one game was at 6. So the people here last night, you know, when the earthquake happened, people were running down tall buildings somewhere in the streets. But after a while, they pretty much calmed down. There were two small aftershocks, 5.4 and 4.8, but we didn't really feel it. So I don't think it's going to affect the spectators too much. In fact, they might even want to be out in an open field.
All right, Dyan, thanks so much for the updates. That was Dyan Castillejo reporting live from Myanmar.